As I write this review, I realize that people think that they know what David Copperfield are talking about here. Truth be told, it's not that one. I was wrong. I didn't even realize till after I watched the movie. Now I'm low-key embarrassed, but here I am writing this review, and damn, that's it. That's all there is to it. I know that it shows me still writing, but there's nothing else to write. Just going to go into the review now. This is a shitty opening skit before the movie review. So yeah, here we go.
It is, in fact, written memory. And you have quite the ride on the way.
We have the personal history of David Copperfield. Let me just start off by saying what I just kind of mentioned a little bit, the obvious elephant on the corner of the room. This movie is not about the magician you all know, David Copperfield, as what I thought it was. Turns out, apparently, there's actually a Dickensian novel from back in the day about David Copperfield, a different Copperfield. Shocker, somebody else famous would have the same last name and first name. But yeah, it didn't quite add up, because this all takes place in, like, a very specific era, which is similar to the era of both Emma and Little Women. And I didn't realize. I was like, wait a second. And I started Googling. I was like, David Copperfield was born in the 70s. What's going on here? This is not a movie about the magician David Copperfield. It's a movie based on the book, which I had never heard of or read until this happened. So this is a Call of the Wild situation all over again, though I'm even less prepared for it. It's not a bad movie. It's pretty good overall. The director is Armando Iannucci. Not a lot of directorial credits. Well, I shouldn't say that. If you go on his IMDb, most recently he's known for probably Death of Stalin. Might be one of the newest ones, which is like a political comedy of sorts. That and this guy also helped to write and direct several episodes of Veep, which is a popular show, I'm told. Again, it's one more show that I haven't watched. This movie has a very, 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 very star-studded cast. Hell, we got Dev Patel as the lead, who, great job. Like, I mean, I believe this character he played. I'm unfamiliar with the character. I thought I was familiar with the character because I'm a fucking idiot. I mean, we have Hugh Laurie, Tilda Swinton, Peter Capaldi, the Doctor himself. We have fucking Captain Phasma and Finn even pop in for some essentially cameos here and there. I don't have any issue with the actors or their character portrayals, but I will say, as an immediate kind of like something that took me out of the film, is that some of the characters really played an exaggerated version of themselves. Like, if they were evil, they were really evil. If they were good, or if they were like silly or ditzy, they were just really leaned into that, which normally is what you're supposed to do. But like, it took me out of it here and there when like a character becomes almost like a pantomime of themselves, like a caricature of some kind. Overall, the film is quirky and charming. I mean, it has its moments. It's not a perfect film by any means, but there's definitely moments where I was charmed, where I kind of, you know, I got into it here or there. Not a lot, though. That was probably one of the bigger cons of the movie, is pacing. I don't know what it was, because, like, the beginning I wasn't getting into it, and it wasn't until some moments in the first quarter and, like, halfway through where I was investing here and there. But I felt like the movie didn't pace its emotional beats very well. The moments where you should have been getting invested, you should have been diving into something, which it did on occasion, but more often than not, I found that there are moments where I would have liked to have more of an in-depth look on something, and then instead we got like longer segments of pieces of the movie that I didn't feel were necessarily necessary, you know? Hard to say. But yeah, that's what I'm trying to get to, is that just the pacing kind of felt off. It felt like things were like boom, boom, boom. Boom, we're over here now, and this happened, now we're over here, and now these characters are here, and now they're gone, oh, but they'll be back again later on. It was all just very quick, essentially, and so that kind of threw off the pacing of it for me. Don't get me wrong, I love everybody who was in this movie. Like, every actor I was a big fan of, just as actors themselves, but I thought that the main guy, Dev Patel, but then also, like, Hugh Laurie, I felt like they really shined through. They had a bunch of really good scenes together. A lot of the mannerisms these characters had were very obvious and in your face. And while, of course, Hugh Laurie's character has his own downfalls in the film, he still had these very subtle quirks that I enjoyed kind of noticing and watching, and I felt for his character. I don't know what, it's hard to pin down. I don't want to go into any big spoilers. Not that this is some big movie to be spoiled or anything, but yeah, like I like Dev Patel and Hugh Laurie's characters the most. I thought they shined through a lot. Overall, I don't have a lot to say about the movie. It was directed and shot well. I mean, everything was clear, well lit. I mean, well done. I will say some of the sets, like early on in the movie, you can tell, I think this movie had a budget of just a little over 15 mil, which is kind of low-ish compared to a lot of films out there, but there were some sets that you can, like, even to, like, the untrained eye, you could really tell they were sets. Not the whole movie. There were some good other, you know, like, well-done locations and other pieces here and there that seemed to come more alive and in-depth look at some characters' lives, but there were just some sets that just, like, surprisingly just seemed like movie sets, which isn't what you want in a movie at all. I was surprised because this was not the David Copperfield magician that I was familiar with. This was instead a new character who, honestly, I like more than the magician who exists currently. Not to downplay his achievements or anything because, you know, of course the name is a household name. But I mean, this character, it's very much, it's another coming of age. It's very, honestly, this movie is the poor man's Emma to me. It's a very, very similar plot. Just, you know, a young boy turned man growing up and then maturing and learning about the world, others around him, how to get by, how to survive. Granted, Emma's born into a life of luxury already, so she kind of is put up on a pedestal. But this character is very much more like, there's no pedestal. He's like in the gutter and then like he gets something and then it's taken away and then gets something and taken away. So in that way, it's very much more like the ebb and flow of the modern man's life. So I do appreciate that component, but not all the comedy hit the way that it hit in something like Emma, and the more dramatic moments didn't hit as hard as they did in for like Little Women, for example. I know I gave Little Women like an average rating, but when there were emotional moments in that movie, they fucking went boom. Like, I would say overall, and this was kind of what just popped into my head. Granted, it's only like out of a 5-star rating system. But I would give The Personal History of David Copperfield, released technically in 2020, though if you go online, it first says 2019, but if you go on IMDb and literally anywhere else, it says 2020, so I think maybe the American release was 2020. But anyway, The Personal History of David Copperfield, released in 2020, I give it a solid, if not low, a solid 3 out of 5. It is an average film. Is it something I would recommend to go out and check out in theaters? Probably not. Is it something I would say, like, you know, check out on Netflix when it comes out inevitably, or rent it for a night if you just kind of want, like, something like a nice family flick? Because it's PG. I don't cover a lot of G or PG movies on my channel here, but here we are. Yeah, it's a good family flick. As the franchise put it, it's a movie that, you know, you would be seeing, your grandparents would play at their house maybe, or like, they're like, oh yeah, you know, we're gonna watch Big Fish, and then we're gonna watch the Personal History of David Copperfield. That'll be interesting, right there, Timmy boy? Something like that. So, yes. On the short of it is, that's my review. I really wouldn't go out of your way to see this one. It's just an average film. If you're a big film connoisseur, if you like the original work by Dickens, or you're a fan of all these actors that are involved in it, then check it out. It'll be worth your time. It's a fun little watch, but it's nothing to write home about, and it's definitely not going to grace my top 10 list for the year. So it's about all there is to it. As usual, thank you guys and gals so much for watching. I always appreciate the support. If you want me to review any movies, put them down below. Expect new reviews coming up soon. As always, this year is definitely not over, and I plan to play catch up from all the months I missed in summer. So thank you guys and gals so much for watching, and stay tuned for the next movie review. Goodbye, travelers.